Hello friends, in this video I will be discussing the introduction about thermal methods of analysis. As you know, there are many important thermal methods which are used in analytical chemistry, and some of the important thermal methods are DSC, that is differential scanning colorimetry, TGA, that is thermogravimetric analysis, DTA, that is differential thermal analysis, etc. So in this video we will be discussing the basics of all these thermal methods. Now here question arises, what happens in these thermal techniques? So in these techniques, a physical property of any substance will be monitored by the function of the controlled temperature change. So let's see the details about these techniques. So in these thermal techniques, a physical property of a substance is monitored as a function of controlled temperature change. Means here we will change the temperature of that particular substance or sample. Generally we will increase the temperature, and by increasing that temperature there will be some sort of changes in the physical property of that particular substance, and that physical property will be measured by using these techniques, by using these thermal analytical techniques. Now here question arises, what are those physical properties which can be measured by these thermal techniques? So first property which can be measured by thermal methods are weight loss by heating. Weight loss by heating. So when we will take any sample, then we will provide heat or heating of that sample, then there may be loss of the weight, and how much weight is lost, that will be measured by using this technique. Now coming to the second parameter, that is melting point. So by using these thermal techniques we can also determine the melting point of that particular sample or substance, and the melting point is also a physical property of a substance. Now coming to the third property which can be measured by using these techniques, so third property is heat and energy transitions. So in any sample, if any heat or energy transitions takes place, that is also a change in the physical property, and those properties can also be measured by using these thermal methods. Now coming to the fourth property. So fourth property is change in form. For example, if we are having any solid sample, and after heating it will be converted in the form of liquid, or it will be converted directly from solid to the gas. So there will be change in the form, and that can also be measured by using these techniques. Now coming to the next property. So dimension is also a physical property which can be changed by heating or change in the temperature, and it can also be determined by using this technique. Now coming to the next property. So there may be possibility of samples which may be showing this viscoelastic properties. So those properties can also be changed by heating. So here question arises, what is viscoelastic properties? We know viscosity, we know elasticity. For example, if we will take this sample, this is solid sample, if we will stretch this one, so there is no elasticity, so there is no change in the shape of this particular sample. For example, if we are taking this rubber band, so here elasticity is there, so when we will stretch this rubber band, so its shape will be changed, it will be stretched, so it is elastic but it is not viscous. But here if you are taking the example of toothpaste and we will take out this toothpaste, then this toothpaste contains both property. First one is elastic and second one is viscosity. So whenever we will put this toothpaste in any kind of container, then it will take the shape of that particular container due to this viscoelastic properties. Means viscosity is also there plus elasticity is also there. Water is also the example of viscoelastic material. So there will be change in these viscoelastic properties due to heating. Now coming to the applications of these physical properties. So these physical properties are very useful in material science, which includes So these physical properties are used for material characterization. It is also used for determination of purity of medicinal substances. It is also used for study of relative heat stabilities. It is also used in crystallography. It is also used in chemical kinetics, and these physical properties are also used in generation of phase diagram for various samples. So these are the introduction about various thermal methods. Now coming to the different types of thermal methods, which are very important in analytical chemistry. So here first method described under these thermal techniques are thermogrammetric analysis or TGA. Sometimes it is also known as thermogrammetric or TG. So parameter will be mass or weight, both are same. So instrument used for this method will be thermobalance, and a typical curve will be drawn between mass versus temperature, or we can say mass versus time. Now coming to the second method. So second method under thermal analysis is derivative thermogrammetric analysis, that is DTGA. So here parameter will be small change in the mass divided by small change in the temperature, and instrument will be thermobalance, similar instrument, and here typical curve will be draw between dm by dt versus temperature. Now coming to the next technique, that is differential thermal analysis or DTA. So third method is differential thermal analysis or DTA. So here parameter will be delta T, means heat evolved or heat absorbed, means change in the heat. Then instrument name will be DTA apparatus, and here typical curve will be drawn between delta T versus temperature. Now coming to the fourth method under thermal technique, that is differential scanning colorimeter. सो लास्ट एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट टेक्निक अंडर दीज मेथड्स आर डिफरेंशियल स्कैनिंग कैलोरीमेट्री, दैट इज ऑल्सो नॉन एज DSC. सो हियर पैरामीटर विल बी स्मॉल चेंज इन द हीट डिवाइडेड बाई स्मॉल चेंज इन द टाइम, एंड द इंस्ट्रूमेंट नेम विल बी डिफरेंशियल कैलोरीमीटर, एंड हियर कर्व और ग्राफ विल बी प्लॉटेड अगेंस्ट DH/DT वर्सेस टेम्परेचर. सो दीज आर द वेरियस थर्मल मेथड्स विच विल बी डिस्कस्ड इन अपकमिंग वीडियोज इन डिटेल्स. नाउ कमिंग टू द थ्योरीज इन्वॉल्व इन दीज थर्मल मेथड्स. सो इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एनी थर्मोडाइनेमिक इवेंट, देन इट इन्वॉल्व्स आइदर लॉस ऑफ हीट और एडिशन ऑफ हीट. सो ड्यू टू दिस प्रोसेस देयर आर टू पॉसिबल कंडीशंस और टू थर्मोडाइनेमिकली पॉसिबल कंडीशंस. फर्स्ट वन इज चेंज ऑफ टेम्परेचर इन द सैंपल, एंड द सेकेंड वन इज चेंज इन द एनर्जी ऑफ द सैंपल. सो हियर चेंज इन द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द सैंपल एज वेल एज चेंज ऑफ एनर्जी ऑफ द सैंपल टेक्स प्लेस ड्यू टू चेंज इन द टाइम. सो दीज थ्योरीज आर इन्वॉल्व इन दीज थर्मल मेथड्स. सो दीज आर द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ वेरियस थर्मल मेथड्स. नाउ इन माई नेक्स्ट वीडियो आई विल डिस्कस द डिटेल्स अबाउट थर्मोग्रेविमेट्रिक एनालिसिस. थैंक यू.